Sean Khalifa, from man.
Two chains.
Money's the motivation, money's the conversation. You on vacation, we getting paid, so we on vacation. I did it for the fam. It's whatever we had to do, it's just who I am. Yeah, it's the life I chose. Gunshots in the dark, one eye closed. And we got it cooking like a one-eye stove. You can catch me kissing my girl with both eyes closed. Yeah, perfecting my passion, thanks for asking. Couldn't slow down, so we had to crash it. You use plastic, we bout cash. I see some people ahead that we gon' pass, yeah.
I never fear death or dying. I only fear never trying. I am whatever I am. Only God can judge me now.
One shot, everything rides on tonight. Even if I've got three strikes, I'ma go for it. This moment,
hey guys, welcome to another wonderful, wonderful little episode here of Feast of Gaming.
Yeah, it's buddy.
Joe and?
Ant.
And we're here doing a quick little review on this Need for Speed 2015. We just decided to give you some gameplay, made a little cool intro, figured it'd be pretty cool and exciting, keep everybody watching. And yeah, let's get right into it. Well, as you can see here, everything's mapped out, everything is online, first of all. There's no like offline mode whatsoever. I hate when games do that.
Yeah, it's kind of dumb.
I don't understand why they do that. They just feel that everything has to revolve around online, and it takes away from it. You have story missions, and then you have private missions, and then you can also challenge people to quick races while they're on, you know, in your map online. Cool little way to change it up, I guess. But to me, still, I mean, the story mode is tied in to the online, so you have to go through the story mode actual missions to get your little story gameplay. But why couldn't they just put in a story mode and call it a day?
Right? Sometimes I like to be left alone when I'm playing my story modes.
Yeah,
not seriously. Bothered by people online crashing into you and blowing your car up.
Oh, Grand Theft Auto. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Or getting mauled by a tank, and then the guy just magically knows where you spawn next and freaking blows you up again.
Right.
Especially when you're like me and I have no money and nothing online anyway, so it doesn't matter. Right. I swear, it was terrible. But
that's how this game's going, too, because you get them random players on here that run right into you in the middle of a race.
Exactly.
Like, all right, awesome.
Graphically, it's a step up, but it's not, I don't think it's that great. I think that they kind of did the same old Need for Speed thing, you know? Right. Extra gloss on the floor.
The raindrops look
the
great.
The raindrops, yeah, exactly. And then, you know, you've got typical graphics that are maybe a little above last gen, but not really full next gen, not in my opinion. I don't think so.
Yeah.
It's kind of that mix in between. I think they just played it safe. Looks like they wanted to get the product out pretty quick. And, I mean, I like it. Don't get me wrong. I don't mind playing it. I think it's going to be a decent racing game, but I want more.
Yeah, I've had better.
I've definitely had better. And that's one of those things. And as you can tell, I mean, I'm not good at this game anyway, so don't laugh. We hit everything. We do all that stuff. We're
right.
Great. It's definitely new. I mean, you've got some little things that they changed in some ways that you see they're trying to evolve into, like I said, with the online and stuff like that. It's, you see the change in them. They're trying, but they're not exactly doing it the right way.
Yeah.
I mean, I would have scrapped the whole game down, kind of redone everything, rebuild the cars, rebuild all the models, and just kind of do it something fresh, something different. I think,
There's no pizzazz to it. There's no appeal that makes me want to go out and buy this game above all other racing games.
Yeah, yeah.
And, it's Need for Speed. It's just plain and simple.
I mean, that's kind of what it is, though. Arcade-y kind of, racing. But then again, you put it up against a game like Forza or something, and that thing's, like, beautiful.
Right.
Compared to this. I mean, it is, too. It's immaculate.
Right.
For the typical, street racer type person or somebody who wants to have fun with it, man, it's good. It'll work. It's going to hold me off a little bit there and keep me going for a little while, but in no way, shape, or form is it really going to get me back into racing games.
That's true on my behalf, too. Because, still in this one, right, you have all the, you can build the car from the ground up, technically, still.
Yeah.
And, that's only fun for so long.
It is.
You max out your car, you go and do a few challenges, and then you get bored. So yeah. It's like, yeah.
You make them look cool, but they all kind of function the same.
Exactly.
All right. Well, anyway, I'm going to give it a solid 6. That's mine. What do we think, Ant?
Yeah. It'll hold you over if you just feel like doing a few challenges, racing, normal stuff, you know, nothing spectacular, but yeah. I'll give it a solid 6.
Dude. All right.
I've had better.
Well, at least we're in agreement on this one. So right. Anyway, guys, you know, I hope you enjoyed some of the gameplay and like I said, the pretty cool intro, and
check it out yourself if you really want it.
Keep it feasted, guys.